Dear learners, you all are invited to my class. We are again in the class with the topic sentence connector. In our last class, we discussed about sentence connector and different rules. I expect you are attentive to my lesson. Please, everybody try to be devote yourself to my class. Please, let us learn about the sentence connector. Dear learners, we know sentence connectors are used to connect different parts of the sentence. Let us see number 9, to present condition. In order to present the conditional sentence, we have to use this type of sentence connector, like if, unless, in case, as long as, till, until, provided that. These are the sentence connectors used in a conditional sentence. Number A, you will cut a sorry figure in the exam. You are sincere. Here you see, it is affirmative sentence. That one is affirmative sentence, you are sincere. And we have to know you will cut a sorry figure and you are sincere. It is opposite idea. So in this case, we have to use the sentence connector unless in the gap. So sentence is, you will cut a sorry figure in the exam unless you are sincere. So we use the sentence connector unless. Number B, phone me. You fail to find my house. Phone me in case you fail to find my house. So we have to use in case in this gap. Number C, I won't stop crying. You let me go. Here we can use the sentence connector, I won't stop crying until you let me go. In this gap we can use until. Number 10, to indicate time. Now and then we use adverb of time to connect the different parts of the sentence. Here, time indicating conjunction or sentence connector, when, while, before, after, at that time, recently, as soon as, no sooner had, dot dot then, hardly had, dot dot when, scarcely had, dot dot when, etc. This type of conjunctions or sentence connectors are used in order to indicate time. In this first line we see, I passed my SSC in 1986. Dot, I was 17 years old. It indicates time. We can use I passed my SSC in 1986 when I was 17 years old. This when, time indicating conjunction or connectors, we can use here. Number B, at the outset of the sentence there is a gap. We have visited the Cox's Bazar. We can use recently, we have visited the Cox's Bazar. It is present perfect tense, and before this in the gap we can use recently. There is the use of recently. Number C, the student stood up, the teacher entered into the class. In the gap, we can use as soon as. The students stood up as soon as the teacher entered into the class. So, in the gap, we can use as soon as. as soon as is the conjunction or sentence connector used in the gap. Likely, dear learners, we have to know the different rules of using the sentence connector in different sentences. Let us see more about the sentence connector. Number 11, to make conclusion. We know in case of writing paragraph, in the last sentence we try to present the concluding idea and we use the sentence connector like in short, in brief, to sum up, to summarize, above all, on the whole, in all, in total, etc. These are the different sentence connector specially used at the last sentence of the paragraph or any writing. Let us see number A. She gets up early. She prepares homeworks. She goes to college regularly. She is a good student. We know in case of last sentence we have to use this in short. We know the meaning of in short, in brief, to some same meaning, shankhepe. So in the last sentence we can use in short or in brief. Number B, he is a good teacher and helpful to everybody. He is a good man. He is a good teacher, one quality, and helpful to everybody, another quality. And last quality, he is a good man. So in the gap, we can use above all, he is a good man. So in the gap we can use above all, it is sentence connector. So in this rule we know that in case of concluding the sentence or making the idea end, we use sentence connector, and this type of sentence connector we use in the last sentence. Number 12, miscellaneous. As if, as though, as it, meanwhile, in the meantime, who, what, whoever, whatever, etc. Moreover, we can use this type of sentence connector in different sentences according to the demand. So let us see. Number A, I will give you, you want. I will give you, whatever you want. In case of presenting the thing, we can use what. I will give you what you want. In the gap, we can use what. Number B, the camel is the sheep of the desert. The camel is, as it were, the sheep of the desert. We can use as it were. So likely we can use different type of sentence connector according to the demand of the sentence. From first to last, in two classes we got 12 rules related to sentence connector. And dear learners, in your exam you will get a passage like this. Use appropriate sentence connectors in the blank space of the following passage. You will be provided with this type of passage. In the passage, according to the demand of the sentence, you will use 10 sentence connector in 10 gaps. And every word will bear half mark. Half into 10 equal to 5 marks. So let us see. Mobile phone has become an essential gadget for everybody. Number one gap, it has become very popular. Gap, it has created a number of problems. It has, number C, advantage dash disadvantage. it helps to connect people, dash, it helps to exchange information, dash, it can be used for various purposes, it has a few advantages, can cause a lot of problems. Its advantages are more than its disadvantages. In this passage, we get the idea about the good side and bad side of using mobile phone. We know there are some advantages of using mobile phone. At the same time, we have to consider that there are some disadvantages too. And considering all aspects, advantage and disadvantage, advantage of mobile phone are more than the disadvantage. So let us see what can be used in the gap as sentence connector. Dear learners, please, everybody try to solve the gap so that we can use the correct sentence connector in the sentence. Please, dear learners, let's see. Number A, as. Everybody, as it has become very popular. Mobile phone has become an essential gadget for everybody, as, we can use as or since, it has become very popular. But, number B, but it has created a number of problems. It has, number C, both advantage and disadvantage. Number E, firstly, it helps to connect people. Number F, secondly, it helps to exchange information. G, moreover, it can be used for various purposes. Number H, however, it has a few disadvantages. Number I, which can cause a lot of problems. Number J, yet its advantages are more than its disadvantages. In this way, we can fulfill the gap according to the demand of the sentence. Dear learners, let us see another example. In this sentence, something stated as the bad effect of smoking. In our everyday life, we see amongst you, some boys are addicted to smoking. And what is the demerits of smoking? It is stated here. We see smoking is harmful to us in various ways. It causes various diseases, blood pressure, heart attack, bronchitis, cancer, etc. It pollutes air. Smoking causes harm to the smokers, the non-smoker who remain by them. We should give up smoking. It is a great an addiction to get rid of. Nothing is possible for us. We are determined to give up it. We can certainly do so. We are addicted to smoking, and how to devoid this addiction and what to do? We have to know the demerits of smoking and take necessary steps. And it is very important for us to know about the use of sentence connector. Let us see what is the right sentence connector used in the different gaps. Learners, you see, here in every gap there is the sentence connector. Let us see very minutely. Smoking is harmful to us in various ways. It causes various diseases. Number SAS S. We can use in the first gap SAS S. Blood pressure, heart attack, bronchitis, cancer, etc. Number B, besides, it pollutes air. Number C, moreover, smoking causes harm to not only the smokers, but also. Number D, not only, and number E, but also the non-smokers who remain by them. Number F, so we should give up smoking. Number G, true that it is too great an addiction to get rid of. Number I, however, nothing is impossible for us. If we are determined to give up it, we can certainly do it. So likely, we have to use the correct sentence connector in the different gaps. Dear learners, we could know different rules and system of using the sentence connector in a sentence, and you will get your preparation at your house more, you will practice more, and likely we have to practice ourselves regularly. Dear learners, I expect you are very clear about the discussion of sentence connector very smoothly. Every day, regularly, you will practice these items at your house, and I think you will be very skillful about using sentence connector. Remain safe at your house and go on your study. And saying this, I would like to complete my lecture. Thank you.